In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a film gate look in DaVinci Resolve using the Fusion page. When you send film to a lab to get scanned, the lab often overscans the image, including the camera's gate and sometimes even the sprocket holes. Let's look at a reference shot on Super 16mm film. Unlike 8mm, the sprockets do not intrude on the imaging area, and they are not even visible in this overscan. Also, take note of the red glow around the edge of the frame. This is caused by halation of highlights. Let's get started. I've got two nature shots in my timeline that have already been graded with a film print look. Instead of creating a fusion composition for each individual shot, I'll create one fusion composition and add it to the layer above. This will act like an adjustment clip. Open Effects, search for Fusion Composition, and drag this into the second track of your timeline. Extend it to cover all of your clips. Now, head into the Fusion page and start building. Our composition is blank, as is our viewer. Let's fix that. Add a Media In node. Connect it to the Media Out node. And set the media source to background. That's better. If I made any editorial changes to track one on the edit page or increased the length of my fusion composition, those changes would be reflected here on the fusion page. I'll start by creating the camera gate. The rectangle tool is perfect for this. Once inserted, hit 1 to load it in the left-hand viewer. I want to leave a little room around the edges, just like you see in an overscan. 0.9 works great for the height. Today we're emulating Super 16mm film that has an aspect ratio of 1.65. Now, my current fusion composition has an aspect ratio of 1.78. So this is what we're going to do to find out the width of our rectangle. We're going to do 0.9, multiply by 1.65, divide that by 1.78. So the formula is our height, multiplying it by the aspect ratio we want, dividing it by the aspect ratio we currently have. Let's input those numbers. That's looking good. Next, let's curve those corners. That's easy to do by changing the corner's radius. Let's adjust it to 0.03. At the moment, our rectangle is only a mask. Let's make it into a usable image. To turn it into something useful we can use in the composition, we'll feed it into the input of a background node. Load the new background node into the left-hand viewer by selecting it and hitting 1. You can think of the background node as a solid color generator. By default, they're black. Now we can see what we need to do next. Firstly, it's the wrong way around. Head back to the rectangle node and hit invert. Secondly, the edges are a bit too sharp, so let's add some edge softness by dialing up to 0.002. In the reference scans, you could see the gate wasn't perfectly straight, so let's make our rectangle a little wonky. We'll do that by adding a displacement node next. Select the background node so our displace node gets inserted into the right place, hit shift space, type displace, and enter. The displace node works by distorting one image based on another. So we're going to distort the gate by using the fast noise node. First, deselect all your nodes and then open up the fast noise node. Connect its output to the foreground input of the displace node. Putting the fast noise node on the left viewer and then the displace node on the right viewer helps us see what's going on. Now let's turn up the noise. Select the fast noise node. Under the scale controls, amp it up to 20. Immediately, you see its effect on the gate. It's a bit too much though. So let's turn it down by going into the displacement node and decreasing the refraction strength. Now let's apply it to the footage with the merge node. Don't forget, Fusion has that really cool feature to automatically create a merge node. Just drag the output of the displacement node onto the output of the media in node. I'll send the media out node to my right-hand viewer so I can see what the composition is looking like. It's looking really nice, but there's one element missing, halation. The studio version of Resolve has a halation effect. Let's add it. Apply the halation after the merge node. Let's tweak the effect further by decreasing the threshold so that the halation appears more easily, and increase the strength and spread until it matches the look I want. I'll bump the relative spread of red all the way up to 2. The only problem is now the halation is being applied to the entire image, when we just want it applied to the gate. Well, we've already created a mask that's going to fix this problem. Connect the output of the Displace node to the Effect Mask input of the Halation node. And there you go. Now the halation is appearing just around the gate in the highlights of the image. In a future video, we'll look at creating halation without a studio license. In the meantime, let's check out this look. There are a few common mistakes people use when creating this film gate look. For example, the image being visible through the sprocket holes, using stills film edge markings rather than motion picture edge markings, incorrectly placed or spaced sprockets, and incorrect aspect ratios. If you want your film emulations to look convincing, then these details are important. I hope you found this technique fun and helpful. Of course, this isn't a 100% accurate film gate look. However, we did apply some basic principles to make sure that we are mirroring what film scans do look like, and this was a fairly quick and easy method. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe for more.